Hello family, welcome and welcome back to my YouTube channel. In today's video, I'm back with another dinner recipe. Stir fried beef, some fried banana, and some yellow vegetable rice. Make sure you subscribe to my YouTube channel and turn on your notification bell so you don't miss each and every time I post a new video. But for now, let's get to today's video. So guys, I'm going to start by showing you clearly the meat I used in this recipe. I thinly sliced, my steak as shown in the video. So guys, as you can see, I'm clearly showing you the size of my meat. So after that, I'm just going to wash my meat at least twice well as shown the video. So I'll leave it to work that and I'll be right back. After washing my meat, I'm going to set it aside and then I'm going to add some oil to my karai and then I'm going to preheat it until it's super hot. And then all I'm going to do is to add my meat as shown in the video and then I'm going to mix well and spread evenly as shown in the video. And then all I'm going to do is to leave my meat to absorb the oil for a while as shown in the video. So guys, as you can see clearly, my meat still had some water in it and it's just releasing that water out. So all I'm going to do is to let the water drain. It takes a little while. So I'd recommend you wash your meat few minutes before and let it drain well. So all I'm going to do is, so after that, after my water drains, I'm just going to fry my meat until it darkens to brown as shown in the video. So I'll leave it to watch me fry my meat for a while and I'll be right back. So guys, as you can see, our meat is at that stage that I was saying. It has darkened in color. It's brown. So all I'm going to do is to drain the excess oil and set it aside. And leave just enough oil. And then I'm going to add my one medium sized chopped red onion as shown in the video. And then I'm going to mix my meat together well with the onion as shown in the video. So guys, I'm now just going to add my red pepper and my green pepper, my chopped red pepper and green pepper as shown in the video. And then I'm going to mix everything together well and let my onions and pepper fry for a while as shown in the video. So guys, I speeded this up a little bit so the video doesn't seem so long. So you have to leave your onions and pepper to fry for a while. I'm also going to add some black pepper and salt to taste as shown in the video. And then I'm going to mix again as shown in the video. So guys, as you can see, my onions are now at that stage that they are translucent. I'm now just going to add my chopped cilantro or coriander or parsley, whichever word you want to use for it. And then I'm going to mix everything well together as shown in the video. So guys, that is it. Our stuffed rice cake is ready and it looks really good. This recipe was so good, guys. You have to try it, and you also have to taste your food to know how it tastes or how it feels. I don't know which one is right. So I'm just going to set our steak aside and move on. So guys, moving on, I'm going to add some oil to my pot. We are going to be preparing our yellow vegetable rice. And then I'm going to add my 2 medium sized chopped red onion, I'm sorry. And then I'm going to mix it together with the oil as shown in the video. I'm also going to add 2 tablespoons ginger and garlic paste together with the onions. I'm going to mix them together with the onions as shown in the video. So after frying my onions for a little while, I'm now going to add my green peas. And then I'm going to mix it together also as shown in the video. And then I'm going to leave my peas to fry for a little while again as shown in the video. So I'll leave it like that and I'll be right back. I'm now just going to add my 2 medium sized chopped carrots. I already peeled them, prepared them, and then I'm going to mix them together well as shown in the video again. I'm also going to add 1 tablespoon ground turmeric, and then I'm going to mix it together with the vegetables well. So guys, I'm so sorry about this part of the video. I accidentally turned off my camera, I'm sorry, while adding the turmeric. So I'm also going to add 4 cups of hot water. No, cold water. I'm sorry. I'm going to add 4 cups of cold water. I'm also going to add our leftover oil that we set aside, that we drained while making our steak. So guys, as I said, I added turmeric powder to this recipe, and I'm sorry I turned off my camera while doing it. So I'm then going to cover my pot and let my water boil. So guys, after a little while my water is ready. Our water is ready. I'm now just going to add 2 cups of my basmati my pishori rice. I'm sorry. You can also use basmati, it's also good, or any other rice that you feel is good for you. And then all I'm going to do is to mix my rice together well, as shown in the video. I'm also going to add some salt and mix together well. So guys, you have to make sure there's no rice stuck at the bottom of your pot. You have to mix well. And I'm also going to taste to know if I need to adjust any salt to my water or to my rice water. I don't know which one is right, but yeah, that's what I'm going to do. And then, as you can see, I'm mixing again. So guys, I added 4 cups of water, because you know, while cooking rice you have to double the amount of water. So I'm just going to cover my pot and cook my rice until all the water is drained. But guys, in case you're adding water to your rice, you are adjusting water to your rice, you have to use hot water. Just going to start preparing our bananas. So guys, as for me, I don't always directly fry my green bananas like that. It tastes really, really weird for me. I tried it once and tasted really weird, so I'm not going to do that. I'm just going to wash my bananas and then going to add them to a pot. And then I'm going to add some water and a little salt. And then what I'm going to do is to cover my pot and boil my bananas until they are brown. So guys, if you prefer directly frying your green bananas like that, then go for it. But I don't prefer that. So as you can see, my bananas are ready there. As you can see, I'm just going to show you clearly how our bananas look. They look really, really good. So what I'm going to do is to peel my bananas to remove the outer part or the cover. I'm also going to remove those things that look like strings on them. I don't know how they are called, guys, but you have to remove those two. And then all I'm going to do is to leave it like that, and I'll be right back. Thank you. told us, as you can see, your bananas are ready. I already peeled all of them. I'm now just going to divide each banana twice, as shown in the video, and then to each part I'm just going to cut it across, as shown in the video. So as you can see what I'm doing right there, that is what we are going to be doing. As you can see clearly, I'm showing you what I'm doing. So I'm just going to divide them and set them aside. I'll leave it like that. So guys, moving on, I'm now just going to set my bananas aside and I'm going to check on our rice, and our rice is ready guys, and it looks really really good. So I'm going to do is to show you clearly how vegetable rice looks, our yellow vegetable rice, I'm sorry. I'm just going to set my rice aside. Moving on, I'm now just going to add some of my oil to my pan there, as shown in the video. So guys, you're just going to be doing shallow frying. If in case you are frying your green banana without boiling them, you have to deep fry them. But because we boiled our green banana, we're just going to shallow fry them as shown in the video. So guys, I need you to watch me shallow fry my bananas and I'll be right back. So guys, can you see one side of the bananas are ready? You just have to turn them and fry both sides as shown in the video. So you have to leave your bananas to fry until they are a little golden or yellowish. I don't know which one is right, but I hope you know when your bananas are ready. So when they are fully ready, you're just going to remove them from the pan and repeat that process with any remaining banana. So I'll leave you to watch me repeat that process and I'll be right back. So guys, when my bananas are ready, I'm just going to set it aside. So our dinner is ready. Let me know what you think about this video in the comment section below. And make sure you subscribe to my YouTube channel for more videos. And turn on your notification bell so you don't miss each and every time I post a new video. See you in my next video. Bye.